Good morning, friends, and my dear children. I hope all of you are doing better. I have taken a little gap to upload the next video, but your Lalita ma'am is back to upload the next video, which is from nomenclature of organic compounds. Okay, so today we are going to learn about nomenclature of alcohols. Okay, you all know that alcohols are having functional group OH. Okay, so the substances in which OH is there as functional group, okay, how to give name for such kind of compounds. Okay, and you also have learned that previously we have learned a priority order also. So based on the priority order, when to give suffix for alcohol and when to give prefix for alcohol, we will be learning in this video with certain examples. Okay, so without making any delay, let us start with the topic. Okay, so today our topic is what? Nomenclature of organic compounds. Nomenclature of alcohols. Okay, now nomenclature of alcohols, right? So alcohols, you all know, alcohols are the compounds with functional group OH. Okay, now the compounds with functional group what? OH. Okay, now with functional group OH, then you call them as what? Alcohols. Okay, so generally for alcohols we will use the word ol, prefix. For prefix one word we will use, and for suffix also we will be using one word. Okay, if it is used in place of prefix, we use the word hydroxy. Okay, for OH as a functional group compound, the word hydroxy is being used in place of prefix. Okay, and for suffix we use the word ol. Okay, and you all know that prefix, when we have to use, if there are two functional groups are there, okay, then one is treated as priority functional group and another is treated as less priority functional group. Okay, if alcohol is treated as less priority functional group, then how to give name means we have to give prefix for that. Okay, and main priority functional group is given suffix. Similarly, if alcohol itself is treated as main functional group, then we are going to give directly the suffix, which is the word ol, okay, at the end of the name of that compound. Okay, so if we see different examples, then we will be coming to know about that. Okay, so let us start with certain examples, okay, where naming of organic compounds in case of alcohols. Okay, so let us learn with the examples. Okay, so let us start with the simple examples first. Okay, simple examples. Okay, first one is, you all know, ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. okay, it is named as what? Ethyl alcohol, general name. And IUPAC naming, in IUPAC nomenclature, ethyl alcohol only can be written as what? Ethanol. Okay, you all know that here two carbons are there, so root word is eth, and all single bonds are there in between two carbon atoms, so the primary suffix is an, and ol will be your secondary suffix. Okay, now functional groups substances has to be given what? Secondary suffix. Okay, so it is root word, an is primary suffix. Okay, now primary suffix, and ol is what? Secondary suffix. Okay, so the first compound, generally I'm giving example is what? C2H5OH, ethyl alcohol, IUPAC naming is ethanol. Okay, similarly if three carbon atoms are there, we'll go for the second example. If three carbon atoms are there, C3H7, 7OH is there, suppose. C3H7, you all know that it is propyl. Okay, now propyl alcohol. Okay, now general name is what? Propyl alcohol. But IUPAC naming is what? Propanol. Propyl alcohol. But IUPAC naming is what? Propanol. Okay. So like this, we'll generally give the name of compounds. Suppose if you go for two functional groups are there. Okay. Or you have another important thing you will be coming across. Okay. Suppose pentanol is there with 5 carbon atoms. Okay. So you will be asked sometimes the general names are also being asked. Okay. What is pentanol? 5 carbon atoms will be there. Suppose CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Already 4 are finished. Okay. And if 5 carbon atoms are there and 1 OH is being attached. Okay, you call it as what? Pentanol. And numbering you will be giving from that carbon atom, from that end where OH is being attached. Okay, so it is pentanol. Okay, numbering you will be giving from the end where OH is present. So 5 carbon atoms are there and it is what? Pentanol. This is IUPAC name. What is the general name for this compound? It is amyl alcohol. Sometimes in objectives, they'll be asking about general names also. So you have to remember the general names also. Okay. So it is what? Amyl alcohol. Amyl alcohol. Pentanol is also called as what? Amyl alcohol. Okay. So next we will be going for the next examples. If two alcohols are present, we have to use the numerical prefix diol. Okay, now if two alcohol groups are present, if two OH groups are present, okay, you will use the word diol. Okay, now di stands for what? Numerical prefix. Two alcohols are there, so diol is the word you will be using. Okay, if two OH groups are there, okay, use the numerical prefix diol. Okay, diol. Okay, let us see one example for this. So for this example 1, so what is the example? CH2 and both sides OH are there. CH2 this side also one OH is there and this side also one OH is there. Okay. Here two carbon atoms are there. So root word will be eth. Okay. Eth. And single bonds are there in between carbon atoms. So primary suffix will be an. Okay. And for first carbon one OH is attached. And for second carbon also one OH is attached. Then 1, 2 diol. Ethane 1, 2 diol. Okay now. Ethane 1, 2 diol. And this you are commonly calling it as what? Glycol. Okay, now general name, common name is called as what? Glycol. Please remember this. Okay, so let us go for the next example. Okay, this side I am rubbing. Please note down everything. Okay, you will be dealing with different examples so that it will be very beneficial for you. Okay, please without getting disgusted, please continuously watch the video until the end. You will be getting lot many examples and which are very useful for you in your competitive exams. Okay, so please keep watching. Okay, now let us go for the next example where you will be finding 2 or 3 alcohol groups are there. Second example, let us take this CH2, CHOH. Here also CH2 is there and for the terminal carbons also OH is being attached. So totally you will be having what? 1, 2, 3. 3 alcohol groups are there. So here 3 carbon atoms are there. So root word is prop and all single bonds are there. So an is the primary suffix. And for all the 3 carbon atoms, for 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms, 3 OH groups are attached. So numerical prefix will be triol. okay na, propan 1 2 3 triol. Okay, this is commonly called as what? Glycerol. Commonly called as glycerol. Okay, so like this you will be getting certain examples. Okay, we'll see general examples now. Suppose if you can able to see this example, CH3 CH CH2 OH is there, and here one methyl group is attached. Okay, now here in this compound you are having 4 carbon atoms, so generally you will be calling it as butyl alcohol, or in IUPAC nomenclature you will be calling it as what? 2-methyl. Okay, now this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So 2-methyl propan 1-ol. Okay, now 2-methyl propan 1-ol is the name of this compound. Okay, and in other words, you also can call it as what? Isobutyl alcohol. Isobutyl alcohol. Okay, now isobutyl alcohol. So like this you will be getting names. Okay, let us see some more examples. We keep learning examples. Okay, how many examples if you can able to learn, that much perfect we will become. Okay, so let us go for the fourth example. Okay, so what is the fourth example? CH3 CH2, suppose if it is given like this, CH3 CH2 CH, for this OH is connected and to this one CH3 is connected, if the structure is given to you like that. Okay, then what will be the name of that compound? So here as the OH is attached to this carbon atom, you will start numbering from here, and this will be 2, this will be 3. So in the first carbon only one methyl group is attached and one OH is also attached. So 1-methyl, okay, 1-methyl propan, 3 carbon atoms are there, so propan 1-ol. 1-methyl propan 1-ol. Okay, so that will be the name of that compound. Okay, next go for the next example. How many more examples you keep doing, that much perfect you will become. So example 5, if you go for, take this example, CH CH3 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 OH, what will be the name of this compound? Okay, as a carbon, as OH is attached to this carbon, you will give numbering from here, and this will be your next coming carbon. Okay, so only 2 carbons are there in the main parent chain, so it is ethanol only, but for ethanol you are having still 2 methyl substituents are there. Okay, so for that what will be the name you will be writing? 2,2 dimethyl ethan 1-ol. Okay, now what will be the name of this compound? You are giving numbering as 1 for this compound only. So 1,1 dimethyl ethan 1-ol, this will become. Okay, now 1,1 dimethyl ethan 1-ol is the name of this compound. Okay, so next go for the next example. Okay, I'm rubbing this side. Please keep noting down. Okay, when you are learning, compulsorily your paper and pen has to be with you. Teacher is saying to write it in paper, so don't think that if you write it in paper again you will be throwing it away somewhere and you will not find certain important points. So keep noting down, take a copy. Okay, and please keep writing and practice it every day. I keep saying that only, isn't it? Right, now next example we go for, example 6. Okay, so if you see this CH2 CH2 CH2, and two sides only you have OH is there. So here three carbon atoms are there, so root word is prop, and all single bonds are there, so primary suffix is an, and two OH groups are there. That two in what positions? 1, 2, 3. So 1, 3 diol is the name of this compound. Okay, so let us go for the next example. Some of the normal examples we will be learning. Then we will be learning if two functional groups are there, how to give numbering and naming also. So look at this example, CH2, CHOH. Okay, now CH2, CH3. Okay, so here OH, we can connect it to the down also. Sometimes they'll be giving it in brackets. So if you give the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4. So for first position, you have one OH, as well as for second position also, you have one OH. And there are four carbon atoms in the parent chain. So it is butane. Okay, now. So butane 1, 2 diol is the name of this compound. Okay, let us go for the next example. If I write here, can you able to see? Yes, right. So try to give the naming for this compound, CH2CH3. So now you have to give naming for this compound. Okay, so here as OH is attached to this carbon atom, I will start giving numbering from this carbon atom. So 1 will be this, then this will be 2, this will be 3. Proceed towards the direction where more number of carbon atoms are there in the parent chain. Okay, instead of proceeding this direction you have only 2 other carbon atoms are there. But if you proceed in this direction, you have 4 carbon atoms are there. Okay, so you have to give numbering like this, and this will become your substituent. Okay, so if you are giving numbering for the straight chain, okay, then this will be treated as substituent. You are not supposed to treat OH as substituent. Okay, now please understand that point. Okay, so what will be the numbering naming of this compound? This is ethyl group. Okay, now this is ethyl group, so that is connected to what? Second position. So 2 ethyl butane 1 ol. Okay, 2 ethyl butane 1 ol is the name of this compound. Okay, even though here what we call lowest possible number you have to give. Okay, you have to give lowest possible number to that carbon atom to which functional group is attached. Okay, so you have to be very careful with that, right? And next, once look at this example, example 9. Example 9. Okay, CH3C. CH3C. CH3 here also, CH3, CH2, CHOH, and here CH3 is there. Okay, so now you have to give naming for this compound. So here I said you to give lowest possible number for that carbon atom to which the functional group has been attached. Okay, so I will be giving numbering from back. Okay, then the name of the compound will be what? So in fourth position you have 2 methyl groups are there, and in second position you have functional group OH is there. Okay, so what will be the name of this compound? 4, 4 dimethyl. Okay, and here you are finding 5 carbon atoms, the root word will be pent. Okay, so 4, 4 dimethyl, 4, 4 dimethyl pentane 2-ol. So here the substituents positions are what? 2, 4, 4, which is equal to how much? Sum of the substituents positions, locants positions, if you check. Okay, 2 plus 4 6, 6 plus 4 10. Okay, but if you give numbering from front, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 4 will come. Even though it is violating the lowest sum rule. Okay. You have to give numbering in this way only. Let it violate the lowest sum rule. No worry about it. But still, you have to give numbering in this way only, so that the carbon atom to which the functional group has been attached should get the lowest possible number. Okay. So please try to understand this carefully. Right. So next, we'll go for the next example. Okay. Now we'll go for the priority orders. Okay. Let us check with the priority orders. Okay, if alcohol is there, as we are learning about what? Alcohols. Now, you have to understand that than alcohol functional group, you have some other priority functional groups. What are those priority functional groups? Priority functional groups which are having more priority than alcohol. Okay, now priority functional groups which are having more priority. Okay, now which are having more priority than alcohols. More priority than alcohols. What are those? Okay, that you have to understand now. So first thing, you know, alcohols, than alcohols, the main important functional group is acid functional group. Okay, now acid group, more priority than alcohol functional group. Okay, then you also know that aldehydes. Okay, aldehydes. Aldehydes also more priority than alcohols. Then ketones. Okay, now ketones. For ketones, what is the functional group? C double bond O. Ketones. So ketones are also more priority than alcohols. And you also know that even esters also, C double bond O, O, R, esters. Can you be able to see if I write it down? One second, I'll just move it a little so that you can able to see. Okay, C double bond O, O, R means esters. Esters are also having more priority than alcohols. Okay, now let us see some examples where you will be finding across some examples where acid and alcohol is present. Then how to give the name? If aldehyde and alcohol is present, then how to give the name? Like that, we'll be seeing certain examples. Okay, so let us go with the examples. Okay, let us see. This side, I'm rubbing. So, first one, let us see the examples. If alcohols and acid together are there in the compound. If acid and alcohol. Okay. Together are present in a given compound. If both are there. Okay. If both acid and alcohol both are there, then you have to give. For alcohol, you have to treat it as substituent, and acid is treated as main priority functional group. So for such cases, in all these cases, you will be giving for alcohols prefix only. That means hydroxy word you have to use. Okay, so let us see the examples. Okay, hydroxy to be used. Please remember, hydroxy is the word to be used. Okay, so for this, let us take this example. Example 1, CH3, CH. Here OH is there. CH2, CH2, COOH. Okay, so here acid is the main functional group and hydroxy, OH is the less priority functional group. start giving numbering from that end where acid functional group is present. So the position of OH is in fourth position. So the name of the compound is what? 4-hydroxypentenoic acid. 4-hydroxypenten-1-oic acid. Okay, the suffix for COOH is what? Oic acid. Okay, so let us go for the second example. CH3CH, and down here you are connected with OH. CH double bond CH, CH and COOH. Okay, here also alcohol is there. So you'll be giving numbering from that end where, sorry, acid is there. Where acid is present, start giving numbering from that end. Okay, so this will be 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? So now we have to give the naming for this compound. Here in fifth position you have OH is there. So 5-hydroxy hex. In third position you have double bond is there. Okay, be very careful. So hex 3-ene-oic acid. Okay, 5-hydroxy hex 3-ene-1-oic acid also you can write. Here you can even keep 1. However, you will be giving priority, first priority to what? Oic acid. Okay, so like this, if acid and alcohols together are present, you will be giving numbering like this. Okay, so next let us go for the next example. If alcohols and ketones together are present, okay, if alcohols and ketones together are present, how to give the naming? Okay, so case 2 is what? If alcohols and ketones together are present, if alcohols and ketones together are present, how to give the naming for such compounds? So here let us go for the first example. Okay, so CH2OH, C double bond O, CH2, 2 OH groups are there here. Okay, so let us see the numbering and naming of this compound. Okay, so if you give numbering from this end, 1 to 3rd position will be ketone. If you give numbering from this end, 2nd position will be ketone. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so hydroxy is connected to 1st and 4th carbons, isn't it? Hydroxy, OH is connected to 1st and 4th carbons. Okay, so how to give the naming for such compounds? Okay, so 1,4 dihydroxy ketone is more priority than alcohol. So you have to give hydroxy for alcohols and ketone is the main functional group. Okay, so 1,4 dihydroxy, 4 is the root word. So butane-2-one is the name of this compound. So let us go for the next example. Okay, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. Okay, so what will be the name of this compound? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So in fourth position you have one hydroxy is there, and methyl is also being connected, and ketone is there in the second position, and 5 carbon atoms are there. So 4 hydroxy, 4 methyl, pentane 2-one. Okay, this is the name of this compound, right? So like this, if alcohols and ketones are present, you will be giving main priority to ketone, and hydroxy word you will be using for alcohols. Okay, now let us go for the third case, where you will be coming across alcohols present along with aldehydes. Alcohols along with aldehydes. Okay, so case 3 is what? Alcohols with, if alcohols and aldehydes are present. If alcohols and aldehydes are present. Okay, so how you will be giving the naming of this compound? So let us see. So example 1. So CH3, CHOH is there, and CH2, C double bond O, H. So wherever C double bond O is there, you have to just check side of it, what is there. Okay, sometimes just to confuse you, C double bond O, if OH is there, it will become acid. If only H is there, it will become aldehyde. If O is there, COO, and R is there, I mean alkyl group, if it is there, it will become ester. So you have to be very careful whenever you are coming across carbonyl compounds. Okay, so you have to be very careful. Just side of C double bond O, if H is there, it is treated as what? Aldehydes. Okay. So what will be the name of this compound here? Aldehyde is the main priority functional group, and OH is the less priority functional group. So start giving numbering from aldehyde, from the carbon where aldehyde group is present. So this is the way in which numbering you will be giving. Okay. So what will be the name of this compound? In third position you have hydroxy. So 3 hydroxy, butane 1. Al. Butane 1-Al. Al is the suffix for aldehydes, isn't it? Just recall. Al is the suffix for what? Aldehydes. So same like that, if you go for second example, CH3, CH, and here OH is connected, CH2, CHO. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth. So in fourth position you have OH is connected. So the name of this compound is what? 4 hydroxy pentane 1-Al. Okay, so like this numbering will be there if alcohols and aldehydes are present. Okay, now let us go for the next case, where you will be coming across alcohols and esters are present. This is very important. You have to pay attention to this. Okay, alcohols and esters, if both are there, how to give the naming for that compound? Alcohols and esters. Okay, now case 4. If alcohols and esters are present. If alcohols and esters are present, how to give naming for that compound? So let us see these examples. You have to understand it very carefully. Okay, so let us go for the first example, CH3, CH, here OH is there, then CH2, CH2. C double bond O, OCH3. So this is ester functional group, COOR, isn't it? Here COO, and this is alkyl group. Now you have to check whenever you are giving numbering and naming for esters, what is connected to O? Okay, what is connected to O? That you have to treat it as prefix. okay, and this will be your main parent chain. Please understand carefully. Whatever is connected to O, here C double bond O, O, R is there. Okay, so this side you have one connection, one alkyl group connected to oxygen, and another alkyl group R dash connected to carbon. Okay, so whatever the alkyl group that is connected to carbon has to be treated as main parent chain, and the one which is connected to oxygen has to be treated as prefix. Okay, so you have to remember that point. Okay, whenever you are giving name for esters. Okay, and what will be the suffix used for esters? Did you remember? Oate. Oate is the suffix which is to be used for esters. Okay, so let us give naming for this compound. Okay, so here what you have to remember is, here methyl group, one carbon atom is there. So methyl group connected to O. Okay, so methyl butanoate, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pentanoate it is. Okay, it is what? Methyl pentanoate. We have to write like this if this OH is not there, but OH is also there. Okay, so you have to give numbering. OH is there in which position? Fourth position. Okay, so methyl 4-hydroxypentanoate, you have to write. Okay, methyl 4-hydroxypentanoate. Methyl 4-hydroxypentanoate. Okay, so that will be the name of that compound. Let us go for the second example. CH3 C double bond O, O. Okay, now this is your ester functional group. CH, CH, CH3. And to this, OH is connected. Now please check. Whatever is connected to O, that has to be treated as prefix. Now in prefix, you have OH is there as functional group. Here, this is treated as main parent chain. This is prefix, means to be written before the root word. Okay, whatever connected is O, connected to O, here methyl connected to O, you can write like this, methyl connected to O. Please remember that point. Here what is connected to O? Propyl is connected to O. Okay, now propyl connected to O, propyl connected to oxygen. Okay, now though then it will be what? Propyl, propyl ethanoate it will become, propyl ethanoate. Please understand the wordings carefully. Okay, now in that propyl group you have again functional group is there, so give numbering from this end, 1, 2, 3. So 2-hydroxypropyl. Okay, 2-hydroxypropyl, and here 2 carbon atoms only are there, so ethanoate. 2-hydroxypropyl ethanoate is the name of that compound. Okay, we'll see one more example just like this, because for esters you will be having different namings will be there. 2-hydroxypropyl ethanoate. Okay, so I'll be giving one more example for this esters. Okay, so that it will be beneficial for you only. Right? Example 3. CH3. CHOH. Here, C double bond O. And to this O, what is connected? CH2, CH3 is connected. Okay, ethyl is connected to O. Ethyl connected to O. Ethyl connected to oxygen. Okay, so what will be the name of this compound? So in this will become your 1, 2, 3. This will become your parent chain. So in that parent chain you have Actually, what will be the name of this compound? Ethyl propanoate, you have to write. But to that propanoate, hydroxy is connected. That too in the second position. So, ethyl 2-hydroxypropanoate. Ethyl 2-hydroxypropanoate. Okay, so like this, you have to give the naming if alcohols and esters are present. Okay. So, next we will see the examples where you will be finding alcohol to be the more priority functional group. Okay. Alcohol to be more priority. Alcohol as more priority functional group. Alcohol as more priority functional group. Okay, so where do we come across this kind of examples? Alcohol is more priority means it is for amine groups. Alcohol is more priority than amines. Alcohol is more priority than nitro. Alcohol is more priority than halo compounds. Halo means chloro, bromo, like that. Okay, chloro, bromo, such kind of substituents if they are there. Alcohol only is treated as main priority functional group than amine, than nitro group. Okay, amines and nitro compounds. Okay, so in these three cases, you will be coming across alcohol is only considered to be what? More priority functional group. Sorry for the small disturbances. Okay, so let us see one example. Amine and alcohol are present. Amine and alcohol. So what will be the example? CH3, CH2. One example I'll be giving. CH3, CH2, CH2, CHOH. CHNH2 CH3. So what will be the name of this compound? Okay, if you give numbering from back, 1 2 3 4 5, even if you give numbering from front also, you are getting third position only. So let us give numbering like this, 1 2 3 4 5. So 2 amino pentane 3-ol. Here for OH, you are giving ol. Suffix you have to give because it is more priority than amine group. Okay, so like that you have to understand these points carefully. Okay, amine is less priority than alcohol. Similarly, nitro. Nitro and alcohol are present. If nitro and alcohol are present, alcohol is to be given as main priority functional group. So let us take one example for that. Okay. CH3, CH2, CHOH, CHNO2, CH3. Okay. So here what will be the name you will be giving? 1, 2, 3. Even if you give numbering from front also, 1, 2, 3 only you are getting. So 2 nitro pentane 3-ol. Okay, similarly if chloro is present, if halogen and alcohol are present, okay, so let us see one example for that. CH3 CH here chlorine is connected. CH2, 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 OH. Okay, so you'll be giving numbering from back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 4-chloro-pentane 1-ol. 4-chloro-pentane 1-ol. So like this, if chloro is present, you will be giving chloro, if bromo, anything depending on the substituent which has been given to you. Okay, so like this, alcohol along with other substances. We have learnt different examples. Okay, so today I'm going to stop my video up to here. Okay, I hope you all have understood how to give naming for alcohols. Okay, so we'll be meeting you in the next video. Okay, very shortly. Okay, and please keep watching my videos and kindly subscribe to my channel. Share my videos to your friends so that all the children, most of the children has to be benefited with my videos. That is my main motto. Okay, and keep doing your hard work. Your hard work is your superpower. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.